if you've managed to set up your pay-for subscription, then now we can start adding services. A lot of schools have websites. Some of these may be custom developed, or some of them may actually be hosted on WordPress. Now, one of these services you can add to Azure is an app service. So if we go to the option for app services and then select add, you can see again, there are a lot. And what we're going to do is search for the word WordPress. And as you can see, we have a number of options to choose from. We have a standard WordPress installation, or we have hardened WordPress if you actually want to enhance the security. So what we're going to do is select WordPress and then click on create. We now need to add in a name for the app, and you can see that there's a tick in the right hand side and that it's going to go into our pay as you go subscription. Again, it will go into resource group, and we have a name in there already that is selected the same as the app name, and we're going to leave that as it is. The resource group will hold all of the services that are needed for the WordPress installation. The database provider is MySQL, and we just need to do some settings on the database. So in here, we need to have a server admin login name, and we need to enter a password and then confirm that password. We also need to configure some settings for the type of database. So there are three options: basic, standard, or premium. Again, whichever one you select will have a cost associated with it. So we're going to go for the basic, which is the least amount of cost. You can always change this at a later date. So we click on OK twice. And then the final setting we need to do is actually select where the MySQL database will be served from. So we're going to select West Europe and then click on create. What happens now in the background is that Azure will create all the services that are needed for that WordPress installation. So it will create the SQL database and the actual web app. You'll be able to go to the All Resources option and see all of those services. If you look at the top, you can see notifications where we can actually see that the deployment is in progress. So we just need to wait now until that installation has completed. So we're now back in the All Resources, and you can see the three resources that are needed for our WordPress installation. So we have the web app, the database, and the service plan. So what we're going to do is click on the web app. And as you can see, all of the data that we need to, so the data in, data out, graphs, and if there has been any server errors. You can see the URL, and we're going to click on that. And we can see that we actually have a full URL. So heybutacademy.azurewebsites.net. Now, as this is a first installation, it will take a while to load up. But what we will get is the standard WordPress installation. So as you can see, we can select our country, click on continue, and then we can carry on with the configuration of WordPress as you would do for any normal WordPress installation.